Welcome back to our fifth lesson of our GTM for Beginners series. In this video, we're gonna install the Facebook pixel and track conversions. All or more, coming up. Hey there, Measure Geeks. Julian here, back with our fifth lesson of our GTM for Beginners series. If you have followed along so far, we have already installed Google Tag Manager, we have set up our tag plan, and we deployed our first tag with the Google Analytics 4 tag, which is now tracking data into Google Analytics 4. But there is something crucial missing if you do any kind of paid advertising, because you always want to report back to your paid advertising channels, just like Facebook, that somebody converted, somebody took the action on your page, which you intended them to take. And that is very valuable information to optimize your ads later on. So in this lesson, we're gonna set up the Facebook pixel and then also show you how to track conversions. As always, if you want to test your knowledge later on, then head over to measureschool.com/lesson5, where you can test your knowledge. But let's dive into today's video. So here I'm already in our demo shop, and on this side, we have already the Google Analytics 4 tag deployed. Now we want to install some new tags. I put this actually in my tag plan here that I want to install the Facebook pixel. First of all, the general Facebook base tag, which would be the PageView, and then also a conversion tag, which would track if somebody submits a form, and this will send over a lead event to Facebook. I already have the configurations here of my pixel. If you want to test this out yourself, you can go over to your Facebook events manager, and then here you should find your Facebook pixel, or on the settings, there is your Facebook pixel, which you just need to copy. So let's implement this on the page. First of all, our page view, which would be deployed through all pages. We actually did this in the last lesson already. So we just go over to tags here and click new. And then we choose the tag configuration. And we have many different templates available. Unfortunately, the Facebook template is not one of them. Luckily, there is a community gallery where users can submit templates. And we also have one for the Facebook pixel. So right here, this is made by the Facebook incubator, and we can add this to our workspace. Need to confirm that we want to add this. And then we get our template, and here we can put in our pixel ID. Now you can ignore all of these different other settings for now and just go ahead and give this all a name. So we'll send over a page view on all pages. Obviously, we need to still add our trigger here, which will deploy our tag on all pages. Save this, and let's put our browser into the special preview mode where we can see which tags are being deployed live on our website. And if you go back to the tag assistant here, we see our Facebook pixel now fired. This should be on all pages. So obviously we can do a spot check by going to some random page here and hopefully still seeing that our page view is still fired. That is the case. We also have the ability to look into the Facebook Pixel Helper, an extension that you can install to your browser, where we see the page view has been sent over. And then the last method is actually to go into your events manager, and there is something called test events. And here you can test a new event here by entering your URL into this little field and open this on the website. Now this will not happen on this tab because this is not connected to the tag assistant, but here, if I should reload this, you should be able to see something here. Yes, we get a page view, and that happened on our Data Ninja page right there. So with that, we have the Facebook pixel already installed. In order to actually take this live to our website, we would deploy a version. But since we have one more tag that we want to install, we can actually push this to later on and publish this all at once. So let's take a look at the second part that we want to install here, which is our confirmation page. Now this tag is exemplary for all of the different other conversions that you might want to track. Really what you would need to find out is on your page, what are the events that you want to optimize for in order to get more traffic to these and make your users do this action. Now in our case, I just chose a form here, which is just one of many conversions that you could track. Obviously, if we are on an e-commerce store, which we are here, we could also track purchases, which is a little bit more complicated. So for this short and simple tutorial, I wanted to do this in a form. So let's take a look at actually what this action would look like. We go over here to the forms, and I have one prepared here a ninja form. And when we fill that out, we get to this confirmation page. Now, Facebook has many different standard events that you can send over that can be interpreted by Facebook. And you can look at them in the reference here under the Facebook developer reference. So they have add payment infos, for example, one action or add to cart, add to wish list. This is all data that Facebook can then interpret. And therefore, it's a good idea to send over one of these standard events. And here we have a lead, which would fit quite well to our standard form that we are filling out here. So in order to send over such a standard event, we first need to create a trigger that only triggers on this confirmation page that we have right here. Now, we already went to that confirmation page and we can look into our variables right here in order to see, for example, on this container loaded, how variables get filled. Now, variables are kind of like placeholders which Google Tag Manager uses to evaluate whether it should fire your tags. So we can, for example, use the page path and say, if the page path is Ninja Forms confirm, then we want to fire our tags. So I'm going to copy this over here. And if we compare this with other page views, obviously the page path would change based on which page you are on. And therefore, we want to set our trigger to evaluate on this variable. So let's go ahead inside of Tag Manager, go to triggers and create a new trigger, which is not our all pages trigger anymore, but this will evaluate on our page view and it will only fire on Ninja Forms confirm. Now in the configurations of such a trigger, we can choose different events and we'll get to some of these events in a later lesson. What I wanted to do is fire this on the page view. And then only on some page views where my variable, which was page path, contains, or let's go with equals, which is a bit more stricter, Ninja Forms confirm. So this is a trigger that we have now created, which should fire our tag only on our Ninja Forms confirm page. So let's go ahead and now configure our tag for Facebook. Again, I'm going to go to new here and then tag configurations. Let's search for our Facebook pixel. And we need to put in our ID again, which we have right here. And then we have our event names, and there is a standard event name we sent over PageView that's pre-configured like last time. But now we can see all of these different other standard events that are also available. And I wanted to go with lead. So this is what I'm going to choose. And then as the trigger, I'm going to choose our new defined trigger of Ninja Forms confirm. Let's give this all a name. This is still our Facebook pixel for this time, our lead event, which will fire on our confirm form page. Let's save this. We need to click on the preview button again in order to save this and then reload our page. And now it's connected. We are not yet on the form page, so I'm going to go over to Ninja Forms. And just to show you on our tag assistant, our Facebook lead form has not fired on this page view because when we click into it, you can actually see, well, you need to choose an event here. So you can actually see why did this not fire? Well, the page path does not equal Ninja Forms confirm. When we click here on values, it was Ninja Forms. So it's the page view before. Only if we now click on submit, we get to the confirmation page. And now we should actually see, yes, our Facebook lead fired and our container loaded when we click into the lead now gives us the check marks throughout and our trigger actually fired this tag because Ninja Forms confirm equals Ninja Forms confirm, which is right. If you want to see the names again, the page path equals our Ninja's form confirm. So we've now sent off the lead. Obviously, you would do a little bit of a spot check of has this actually been sent in the tag assistant? Yes. Has this been registered here in the Facebook Pixel Helper? Seems so as well. And if we go to Events Manager, we also see now a lead event that has been put into our Events Manager under Test Events. So this is now sent over and you could build a custom conversion of that. It would also show up in your Facebook Ads Manager later on. And you can optimize your campaigns based on that. Well, actually, it's not yet quite implemented because we haven't yet created a version and published this to our website. That's always the last step that we actually need to do. So we'll go over to submit and add a version name here. And then when we click on publish, this will go live to all out our users. So our Facebook pixel with our conversion tracking is now implemented. So there you have it. This is how you can implement a conversion pixel onto your page. We did this on the example of Facebook ads, but obviously you could also do it with your Google ads or your Google Analytics 4. The process might be slightly different, but I trust you will be able to figure it out. If you think you understood everything that you have seen here and actually know what to do, then head over to measureschool.com/lesson5 and test your knowledge. See how well you do in our quiz. But you probably know there's always more that you can do with Google Tag Manager. And actually, we have one more lesson where we are going to install auto event tracking with the help of Tag Manager. So don't miss out on this lesson. It should be over there. And my name is Julian. Till next time.